Welcome back to school, guys. Back to school reactions with Bet in the house. And Bet, who do we have above us? Who do we have above us?
Rodney Carrington live at the Majestic in 2007.
This is video part three. And it is not correct that we will get through it.
Third attempt.
That 3 + 3 = a curse, but we'll probably get it right.
There is not a storm happening outside, so don't worry.
No, we're all good. Here we go, everyone.
Let's do it.
Carrington live at the Majestic, part three. All right, let's get into this.
It's not storming.
It's always better. Fuck, I should have waited.
Right.
She's got bigger titties.
Oh, yeah.
Shit, there's twins.
Oh. Bro.
We had to stop at boobs straight through.
Bro, I used to have these business cards that said select, don't settle. You need to do that with your women, too. Don't just settle for the first one.
You all heard that straight through. And then you hear boobs.
Stupid.
Boobs.
Yep,
you remember when we discovered masturbation, fellas? You remember? We didn't get shit done that week, did we? That's all we wanted to do. This feels great. How come nobody told me about this? We were always made to feel guilty. My daddy would always say, don't be pulling on your pecker. You yank that son of a bitch off. End up like your sister. You know she used to be your brother. Y'all get in here and eat. There ain't no reason we should feel guilty. If God didn't want us to do it, he'd have made our arms shorter.
Okay.
I think that's why the Tyrannosaurus Rex was such an angry creature. I think if somebody would have just jacked his big ass off, he might have been a little more friendly.
There you go. Dude, Barney, the jacked off Tyrannosaurus Rex. Dude, that's what it equates to. That is what it equates to, dude, is Barney is the jacked off Tyrannosaurus Rex.
Oh, shit. The only reason we jack off anymore is because it's just too tiresome getting anybody to have sex with us. And even as a married man, there's a whole process you got to go through. Dinner, drinking, dancing. You can never just show it to her. That never works.
Show it to her. Look.
Huh? What?
Look. Here it is.
Ta-da!
Ta-da!
I've been married 13 years. I will be damned if I'm going to beg for it anymore. It's like I tell my wife, I go, you're it. You're it. I picked you. I can't run down the street. Miss Johnson, my wife won't give me any pussy. Can I have some of yours?
You're it. I picked you.
I can't just run down the street and go, Mrs. Johnson, my wife won't give me any pussy. Can I have some of yours? This guy is off the hook.
It's like I tell my wife, I go, you're it. You're it. I picked you. I can't run down the street. Miss Johnson, my wife won't give me any pussy. Can I have some of yours? I can't. It's just as easier to just take care of it yourself. You know, I get in the closet, take care of it, go mow. It's just easier that way.
And then go mow.
You know? I thought I knew who I was marrying 13 years ago, but after 3 kids and hormone changes, I do not know who I'm waking up with from one day to the next.
Oh,
it's
shit.
Like spinning a big mood wheel, you know. Come on, happy, 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 sad, happy, sad, horny, 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 ah, oh, bitchy, shit!
I can testify to that. Yeah. A little bit.
I don't want bitchy. Horny's the tiniest little slit on the wheel. It's like the Italy trip on Wheel of Fortune. Nobody ever goes to Italy. They always tell you before you get married, take a good long look at your wife's mother, because that's what she's going to look like and act like. And if that's the case, I'm fucked. La, 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 I'm fucked. Can't stand that woman. We was over to her house for the holidays, and I was going through her medicine cabinet to see what she takes. It makes her so goddamn crazy, I couldn't find it. Found these big giant Kotex pads that look like travel pillows.
Oh, shit.
You can pull a sticker off, slap it on the back of your neck, lay down. It's comfortable. I tried it. Oh, shit. I told her, I said, if you got this much flow, you don't need a pad. You need stitches.
Right.
I'm not welcome over there anymore.
I wonder why.
Turns out it all worked out.
Turns out it all worked out.
Every person who's ever had a mother-in-law knows what that means. Oh my God, dude, that is freaking hysterical.
Turns out it all worked out.
Oh, dude. There's
nothing I can do about it now.
Both
it's
my
hard
first
to stay
wives,
married.
Their
There's
moms.
So much temptation in this world nowadays. Did you know there are two boobs to every woman on this planet? Oh. You know how many boobs that is? A lot.
I might have
Adam
to
and
pause
Eve
here.
Had it easy. One man, one woman, one set of boobs, and one rule. Don't eat the apple. Hell, I could have handled that. Don't eat the apple, Rod. Fine. Anything else? Don't put your wiener in her butt. What if I put the apple in there?
As
long
there.
As you don't eat it. You know, the reason you get married to somebody is because you have fun with that person. You're fun. I like you. We're fun. We have fun together. Let's get married. You get married, she gets pregnant, and fun starts packing at shit. Where are you going, fun? Nowhere. Just kind of getting some stuff together. Then one day, fun just goes, fuck it, and takes off. You're like, come back, fun! He's like, fuck you, married guy! Then it's just you and her and complacency. Complacency sets in. You don't give a damn. You let your bodies go. You give me 3 cheeseburgers and 4 donuts. I don't give a shit anymore. She'll have the same. She's married too. The quickest way to fall back in love with your wife is just look at yourself naked in the mirror after you get out of the shower. Oh, thank God I'm married. I wouldn't stand a fucking chance right now. Can't even see my little dick unless we meet halfway. Hello, fella.
Hi, Rodney.
It changes. Her boobs are...
Dude, I might die watching this, bro. This is hysterical.
I mean, you are at that age. You need to be careful with how hard you're laughing.
Shut up. Though. Well, I thought you were talking about my ability to see my pee-pee. Okay, I'll take a cardiac arrest. I thought you were talking about my ability to see my pee-pee at my age.
Well, I mean...
Can't even see my little dick unless we meet halfway. No. Hello, fella!
Bruh.
It changes. Her boobs are longer. They're always looking down. Unless she's laying down and they're looking that way and that way. Must have grabbed one of them and go, look at me when I'm looking at you. She farts now. She used to never fart. I thought, this woman is perfect. Never farts.
Look at me when
Not
I'm
anymore.
Looking at you.
3 kids later, it's like Tarzan blowing into a conch shell. Dogs run up to the window like they're being called. There's a zebra in our backyard. She got in the truck the other night. We left this restaurant, and she pooted, and I swear to God, her ass went squirrel. And she turned on the radio like nothing happened. I said, I think your ass just said a word. She said, no, goddamn, it said squirrel. I heard it. She got to laugh so hard, she pooted again. And the kids were in the back bitching. Tell her to stop, Daddy. It stinks back here. I said, I can't help it. Your mom is a farm animal. You just gotta love her.
Yep.
Just like I do. And I do. And we're gonna sing some songs for you tonight.
Uh-oh.
Yeah, buddy. Before we do, though, I would like to bring out my good friend, my piano player. Would you put your hands together for him, Mr. Bob Hoban? Bob? Darling, when we met, you were a pretty little thing. But your body started changing when I gave you that ring. You're supersizing, no exercising. Get by working out. I double meat with cheese, another helping, please. Baby, that's what you're all about. I pick you up in my pickup truck, but you had to ride in the back. Off at the Sonic Burger, you ate everything in my sack. Darling, please, won't you please think of me? I'd love to have my baby back. My baby back. My baby back. 6 months have passed and you've gained 50 pounds, and I confess you've got a real big rack. But the bad part is when I give you a hug, you got a tumor on your back. You supersizing, no exercising. Goodbye.
Bro, her boobs got big. Yeah, she had two more on her back, dude. Bro, that is hysterical.
Confess you've got a real big rack.
Go.
But the bad part is when I give you a hug, you got a tumor on your back. You supersizing, no exercising. Goodbye, working out. Double meat with cheese, another helping, please. Baby, that's what you're all about. I played football with the boys last night, and you were all-time quarterback. But none of us could ever tackle you, cause you're built like a lumberjack. Please, won't you please think of me? I'd love to have my baby back. Baby back. Put down the rib. Baby back. My baby back. Baby back.
Put down baby the rib.
Baby come back to me. Yeah.
Man, dude. He is so funny, dude. He is so funny. I can't wait to get through more of this series. Man, Bet, thank you. We actually made it through it, dude. I can't believe it.
Oh, my God.
What do you think of him, dude?
He's really funny. I love how he, I mean, especially now that he incorporated that in song into it, I like how he added the musical aspect.
Right, ties it all together. It's just
like, at first, I thought it was just a, you know, like I started vibing, I closed my eyes to vibe, and then all of a sudden I heard that he was going with a skit, and I was like, oh, shit.
Yeah.
Because it reminds me of a country-style Adam Sandler.
Right?
Because that's what Adam Sandler used to do in his stand-ups.
Exactly.
He would throw in his guitar into his... I love that.
Exactly.
I love music.
Great.
I mean,
dude,
music specifically incorporated into stand-up is
dude,
huge.
That is
because
such
you
a
add
good
both
point.
Music... and laughter.
Yep, that is such a good point. That connection, I'm glad you made it, because I wouldn't have thought of it off the top of my dome, but that's true, dude. Adam Sandler, same kind of vibe with that.
Yeah.
Adding that musical element, that is so cool. I love it. I love it.
You just got
it.
You just got the out the you know the out the backwood cowboy
sort of. Yeah, you know,
you've got the outback.
Versus the weird city boy.
Yeah.
So it
fits.
Great
stuff. I really enjoyed watching this with you.
Yeah, dude, that was great. All right, awesome. Well, thank you for being here, guys. We'll see you soon. Make sure you subscribe to Vet's channel, too, by the way. I'll have the link in the description.
At Vet React. Make sure you hit subscribe and the bell button below for Back to School. Make sure you do that.
We got more Rodney Carrington coming. We have more Rodney Carrington coming, but if you have any other suggestions, please put them in the comment section below. And we will see you soon. As always, be healthy, be happy, be good to each other, and stay blessed, right? Peace.
Peace.